Niao, Wish and Stephanie. Hey, this is one of the last videos that I'm going to be filming in the old apartment. Now we have a week overlap between the old apartment and the new apartment, so I have to have qualifiers for which place I'm in. So I wanted to do a video update on my Leitner box. I've been calling it Lictor box, and there's Lictor scale in research. It's like, you know those cheesy questions with 1 to 5, and you're supposed to circle like where you fall, 5 being the highest, 1 being the lowest. That's a Lictor scale. So I confuse that with the Leitner box. And what it is it's time-space repetition in paper form. And I've been meaning to do this for a few weeks because one of the things that has slowed me down, and I'm not blaming the note cards, I'm blaming myself, but one of the things that slowed me down is that my cards got too big. I have about 160 of them now, and it was too much to carry around, too much to look at. I didn't know how much to do each day because doing all of them every day I knew was ineffective. And it was overwhelming, which led to not studying. And again, not blaming, acknowledging, fixing. This is what adulthood feels like. I don't know, maybe. Anyway, but I, as with every process that I do, I can't just take on the general instructions. I have to adapt it for what I want. Because what is nice about the Leitner box is that it's review in a way that's really doable, and from the videos I watched, it sounds like most people spend about 15 minutes a day reviewing that part of their note cards. What it doesn't do is that processing part with the Chinese language where you need to sit with, and this is straight from Sensible Chinese, from Kyle from Sensible Chinese. So it's not my idea, but it's one that that resonates really strongly with me as an English speaker going to the Hanza script. I need time to sit with the character when I first see it. I need time to decompose it. I need time to look at it, to do the animations that my brain is gravitates towards, and to meet and introduce it, to do some small talk with it. I need to sit with it, and that's what Kyle calls processing. To look at the meaning, to look at some sentences, to look how it's used, those kinds of things. That's all processing, and that's not reviewing. And the Leitner box is really good at reviewing, but it doesn't really have room for processing. So I've needed to tweak my Leitner box. Now, there's a couple of things. I don't want to do a video on how to use a Leitner box because there's tons of those, and I'll put some in the show notes if I remember. Sorry, did I mention I'm moving and my brain's sort of everywhere at this point? But basically, the thing is that it spreads out the things that you know. For example, mine's a little different than a lot of folks because I've got the note cards I've already made. There's about 150 here. And this is just supplies in the front. I've got the things that hook into here so you can carry them around, which apparently I won't be doing much anymore. And then I've got the ones I've already made, which I'm trying to figure out what to do with. And then you've got numbers 1 through 7. 1 through 7. That's my reminder. Oh, that's the new stuff. And then there's 1 through 7. Can you see the numbers? Yeah, 1, 5, 6, 7. And so what you're supposed to do is, I saw a video yesterday where somebody took 15 of their flashcards. Again, the flashcards are already made. I'm assuming their processing time is when they make the flashcards. But I didn't see anybody talk about that part of the system. They talked about how to use the box itself, but not processing part, and with Chinese, that's a really important part for me. So, I've actually included a new step in front of step one called process, and so I'm going to put cards in there. And before I take my 15 cards of the day, I'm going to be processing them. And I'm not exactly sure how I'm going to do that yet, but I wanted to put a space in the front to remind myself, don't just jump into reviewing, spend time with the new cards. Now, all of these are not new. Some of them feel newer than others, but I've spent time with the vast majority of these. So most of these will go straight into 15 at a time, into 15 per day, will go into the process. So how do you do this? So you take 15, and I've got 15 identified today. Ta-da! And again, some of these are gonna feel better than others. And so the general rule seems to be is, from the few videos that I watched, is that if you can do the meaning, and for me, I want to make sure I can do maybe not the correct sounds, but something similar, and I need glasses for this. So for me, I'm not testing myself on being able to draw, to write it, but I do want to know the meaning and the sounds, at least how to spell it in pinyin. The tones, they're on the cards, but I'm not testing myself on that yet. So, as I do this one, this is going to be a full example today of 15 cards. I'll show you what happens to the cards within the seven thingies. Oh, I need one more thing. Hold on. I need to go run and get my thing. Okay, my thing being this calendar that I've been using. So, they said to, like, print out, because there's, on some days you'll be reviewing cards from section one. Sometimes you'll be reviewing section two and section one. Sometimes you'll be reviewing section five and section one. So it changes which of the seven you'll be using in any given day. And there's a system to it that that somebody figured out, the gentleman that it's named after. And so they said to print it out and attach it to your box. However, I don't have a printer, and printers are a pain in the butt to find in China. So I've actually just put at the bottom here the L. That's section two, section one, section three, section one, and you see how it goes. And so I've done that for a few weeks, because with any system, I want to try it out before I commit to 64 days, which apparently is the length of doing this. So I put it in there for a few weeks. So it tells me which sections to review that day. So if we look at today, today's day one. So there isn't actually a lot. I'm supposed to, and it's odd that they do this on day one, I'm supposed to look at sections two and section one. Now, I did do this a little bit yesterday because I wanted to see how the process worked. Did I put anything in two? No, because you only go up one level. So there's nothing in two, so I can't do that today. That could be a flaw in the system, is on the first day you review something that doesn't exist. But we're going to keep going anyway. So, and then section one. I'm supposed to review section one before I do new ones. Whoops. See, I've already failed. So we're going to put this back into new, and we're going to review section one. Okay, so section one. So this is to write. I'm not looking at the back. I'm actually holding the back here, so I can't see it. This is to write, and it's xie. Xie, xie, xie. And that is correct. So that was in section one. Because it's correct, I go up, so it goes into section two. So the next time I review section two, there's something in there. If it was incorrect, and for me, that's two parts, the meaning and the sound. So if it was incorrect in either of those, would I, and there's some discrepancies, you either keep it in one or it goes down. And for me, I need to think about that. If the sound's wrong, if the meaning's wrong, if either one of them is wrong, I think I would go down to processing, because both of those are super important. If the tone's wrong, I don't care about that right now, but if the meaning's wrong, then just the meaning or the sound. I mean, that's what makes it a word, so no, I think I'd put them back down into processing, not even into new. And I think that's why I wanted the different section of processing versus new, because new, you just start reviewing right away, but processing means you sit with it. Like, I sit with it, I go into Pleco, I look at it, I stare at it, I press the audio button a few million times, I look at sentences, and I spend more time with it. And I think if I keep forgetting what it means, it needs to go down. So I don't think I'm going to keep them in the same one. I think I'm going to do what some people do, which is they go down a level. Oh, no. Beijing. Oh, that's correct. Number two. Ooh. Number five. Not to be confused with part five of the box, it actually is just the number five. So that goes in number two. Shu is book. That was correct. Number two, oops. Oh, that's confusing. So I'm putting them behind, not in front of the number. Whoops. See, it's a good thing to know your box. Duo is how many? My handwriting sucks on that. I need to fix that. And that is correct. Number two, we're almost done. There's not that many in here. G is the hat guy. So this is J. See, there's hesitation still, which means I needed to review that more before moving it up, and I think I'm gonna keep that in one. I think if I stall like that, but I generally get there within a minute, I'll keep it in one. If I completely can't think of one of the two, meaning or sound, I think I'll move it down. Yeah. Oh, this is cat. Mao. 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 Flat tone. Mao. That's close enough for me. It was just the tone that was off. So it goes into two. This is g. And what is the tone on that? I didn't write that one down. It's falling tone, really. G, g, usually jigga, right? Jigga. Knee. Knee, what tone is that? Knee, 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 you. Number two. And cha. Possibly one of my favorite things in the world. T. And that goes into two. So that's the review. So you do the review of the number that's on there, and then you go into the new ones. And this is the one that's interesting to me because I've got that new processing step. So if I really stall, then I'm going to put it down into processing and spend some time with those. I already have some from yesterday in there. Mostly it looks like ones that I forgot. Like generally speaking, I don't remember that one. I know it means Chinese language. The irony is not lost on me. But I think it might be the how it's written, so I probably need to check how I wrote that and rewrite it. So there's that. Okay, so I'm gonna do the new ones real quick offline, and I'll come back and talk to you about it. Okay, so I think it's about half and half. Half of them I moved into section one, and half of them I put into processing. And I kind of expected that because the last 30 HSK1 cards that I made, flash cards that I made away from my phone, and I made them rather quickly, and I didn't really process them very well. So I'm not surprised at all. And I'm just grabbing, I still have all of these here from the 150 HSK1 cards, and I've got the ones that I did process correctly and the ones that I didn't all mixed up together. So I'm hoping, like now in the process section, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Thank you for watching me count. I've got 11 of them, so I have to determine how many I want to process per day. I need to think about that for a little bit because I am pretty sure have signed up for the HSK test on February 11th. I bought a book, and I'll show you that in another video, but I bought a book with some practice tests and some things to prepare for the actual physicality of the test and the different test questions and all of that kind of good stuff. Because as a language assessment consultant, somebody who does language testing for a living, I find it's very important to walk into a test aware of what's on the test, not just the vocabulary. Vocabulary is a huge part of it, and they do have pinyin in HSK1, which is the test I'm going to take on February 11th. But I don't want to use that as a handicap. I want to be familiar with the Hanza characters because I'm looking at this long term. So far, I like the box. I clearly need a bigger box because HSK1 and HSK2 are going to be 300 combined, and this is only about 160 cards. And I'm not really, I can't close it, and I wouldn't really travel with this. But it's not really a self-contained box. It's kind of sticking up and clunky. So I think I need what a lot of the folks were showing, that kind of longer box. So I'll look for that. Until then, this works out perfectly fine. I can just put it on a dresser. I probably need to get a dresser then. Anyway, I'll put it somewhere. I will find a place. But I like this so far. I like time-space repetition. And I like adding a processing step. And I think what I'll do is part of the day I'll spend doing this process, the reviewing process, and then in a more serene, less rushed part of the day, I'll take probably two or three of the processing ones, sit down with them, spend some time with them, and then I'll move them to the new thingy. And if they keep going to processing, then so be it. But I need to spend more time on them. I don't think I want to do more than two, because like I said, the test is. But it's today, January 28th or 29th. I've got a calendar right here. Today's January 28th. So I've got, just for perspective, I have two full weeks. I have two full weeks. So we'll see how it goes. I imagine with 15 cards, reviewing 15 cards a day, I will, that will be 10 days of the 14 days. Might have to do a little more than 15 a day, although that's fine because I still have to study for the other parts of the test too, not just the vocabulary. So I think that'd be okay. I think a large percentage of these are going to be reviews, so I think 15 a day is still realistic. If I really get time crunched, I can do 20 a day. And if I run out of things to process, I can look for ones that I don't recognize and just throw those over into the process section. But I think this will work pretty well. It'll alleviate the time and the stress of studying, of not knowing how much of the giant stack of 150 to study, and it'll give me some time to attack the book and practice the test itself and see the other things that are in the test and to do the listening parts, which I really haven't done a lot of in sentence form, which I don't even know if that's part of it yet. But I'll talk about the book later after I use it for the first or second time. I want to get some practice with it first before I talk about the process with that. So yeah, so I think I'm going to add how many I'm adding per day, which is the P here is processing, how many I process that day, and this is the review, is the lightener box. So I think that's it. I think figuring out the percentage of how many I remember out of all of them is kind of a waste of time at this point, and I need to spend more time on processing the ones I don't know, working on the test, and getting more full sentences. I have a full sentence example that I did, and I think that's another video that needs to happen. So I'll show you that when I get a couple more of those down, but I'm pretty excited on how much easier that is than I thought it would be. So there's a lot happening again. I seem to go through moments where I hit a wall and don't know quite what to do next, and then a floodgate happens and I'm back on board. It's just a matter of constantly getting back on track. I'm constantly falling off of the study wagon. And the good news about a monthly view, I love monthly views of goals, is that I can see, okay, I had 1, 2, 3, 4 days. I didn't even mark off the 4 day as no activity. I just left it completely blank. So I see there were 4 days of activity, non-activity last week. But then it's Sunday and I'm already starting this week with 1 day of activity, so of studying activity. So I feel pretty good about this now, and there's 2 weeks to the test, so I've got an external pressure, which I'm pretty excited about. And I said I think I'm taking the test because my company has offered to arrange it and to set it up and to pay for it for anybody in the company that wants to, and I haven't gotten confirmation that I'm definitely doing it on that day, but that is the day that I requested. So I'm going to assume it's happening, because in China, things are, the general pattern of planning is things are stalled and stalled and stalled, and you don't hear anything until it happens immediately. So I'm going to assume that it will happen immediately, and I want to be ready for it, because I want to have that first HSK high percentage experience and getting used to the test itself. And I am adding new HSK2 cards as I go. I'm probably doing one of those a day. Slow down on that because they have to go into the process part, and I do mostly want to focus on HSK1 at this point because that's the first test. But if I can do a flashcard a day or 7 flashcards a week, 10 flashcards a week, that'll help me later when I need to start processing those for HSK test 2. So I like this process so far. I don't know how mobile it is when I start to travel more for work again, but I'll figure it out. Maybe it can fit in this thing. Thought it wouldn't be too bad in the suitcase, right? I don't know. I don't know exactly what happens once you hit number 7. I think they come out of here. So maybe this will work in the long term. I just have to get better dividers, I think. Okay. Anyway, that is my lightener box in a nutshell, or in a plastic shell. Oh, what a terrible joke. Anyway, if you've used lightener boxes, a physical lightener box before, not just time-space repetition, I'd love to hear your experiences down below in the comment sections. What language have you used it for? How much vocabulary did you use it for? And how did you know when you were done with certain cards? Other than reaching level 7, like if you study every day for a while and a card reaches level 7 because of sheer repetition, is it definitely in your long-term memory, or do you bring it back in every now and then to make sure? I don't know, I'm curious. I'm a little skeptical that after 7 rounds you would definitely have something in your head. Because I think if you didn't use it for a while, it might go away, and I'm a little worried about taking things completely out of the box. So there might be, in addition to the initial process of adding, well, the initial step of adding a process step, I think I might add a, at some point, just make sure, review it, and just shove it back in slowly kind of test. Maybe rotate it back through. I don't know. I don't know. I'm thinking about that. Thinking how to tweak the Lightner box to make sure the stuff doesn't leave my head. All right, so that is my vocabulary tool of the month. And hope, well, it's 64 days of a Lightner box, so it might be more than 1 month if it goes well, which it sounds like it will. So, thank you very much for watching this, and Satchien, goodbye.